At one point or another, you have probably seen a balancing scale in one of your science classes. People use balances to compare the weight of objects. If the two objects weigh the same amount, both sides of the balance will be even. If one of the objects is heavier than the other, the scale tips, and one side will become higher than the other. In math, we like to think of equations like balances. The equal sign acts as the middle of the balance, and the expressions on either side are the pans. For an equation to be balanced, both sides have to have the same value. Let's look at this concept with a model. In this video, we're going to learn how to solve one-step equations using addition and subtraction with models. Before we get started, let's look at the pieces that we will use in our model. You may hear these pieces being referred to as algebra tiles. First, we have a rectangle, which represents an unknown value or x. If the rectangle is yellow, it represents a positive x. If it is red, it represents a negative x. We also have small squares, which represent one unit. If the square is yellow, it represents a positive one. A red square represents a negative one. Let's start with the problem x plus 2 equals 10. Remember that the equal sign represents the middle of the scale. To model x plus 2, to the left of the equal sign, we will use a yellow rectangle, which represents positive x, and two yellow squares, since the equation has plus 2. On the right side of the equal sign, we will have 10 yellow squares. Now, we can begin solving. Before we do, remember that our goal is to keep our equation balanced. And just like the scales we use in science, what we do to one side of the equation, we have to do to the other side, so that it is balanced out. When using the models, we're trying to get all of our x's, or in this case rectangles, on one side, and all of the squares, or our units, on the other side of the equal sign. Notice that the left side has a rectangle and two squares. If we remove the two squares on the left side, only the rectangle will remain. Remember, what we do to one side, we have to do to the other, so we must remove two squares on the right side too. After removing the two squares on each side, we are left with one rectangle equaling eight squares. Therefore, the answer to our problem is x equals 8. One nice thing about solving equations is that you should never get the wrong answer. The reason is because you can check your answer to see if it makes the equation true, and you should always do this. If you take the answer, in this case 8, and plug it back into our original equation, which is x plus 2 equals 10, we would have 8 plus 2 equals 10. 8 plus 2 equals 10, and 10 equals 10, which is true. Now, we can move on from that problem with 100% confidence, knowing we got it correct.